What's up, man? We are your hosts, Justin
and Hannah.
H2E Hip Hop Explosion 15. Mm-hmm. Don't miss out.
South's been most fun.
Would y'all do me a favor and make some noise for Justin and Hannah, and they'll take you the rest of the way to the show.
Justin.
How y'all doing tonight? Come on, hear me, how y'all doing tonight? All right, so we want to thank everyone for coming out. This is H2E15, so that means we've been doing this 15 years strong. I just want to give you guys a few points of advice. This isn't the Alpha Apollo, so there is no booger. These contestants work very, very, very hard. And we also have cash prize, so first place we have $750. Woo! Second place is $500. Woo! And third place is $250.
Prizes, I think, yeah? That's what I want to do. I love that. So, our theme this year is, where do we go from here?
I'm nervous, excited, it's like everything I want. I'm not really nervous that I'm going to mess up. I'm just nervous and ready to get it over with.
Okay, tell me your name.
My name is Daria Keefe, and I'm a freshman, and my major is nursing.
And you are going to
be singing I Was Here by Beyonce.
Okay, awesome. So is there any way we can get your product or anything like that, or a website or a Twitter name or anything like that?
Follow me on Instagram at beauty_love_passion.
All right, awesome. Well, good luck.
Thank you.
All right.
Well, she's a nursing major, and she's gonna sing for us today. So please welcome Daria Keefe.
Just with class and with hard work and just with dedication.
You did a great job.
Thank you.
And you look very beautiful.
Thank you.
So, getting ready to go on, how do you feel?
Feel good, feel excited.
Okay, so tell us exactly what you're getting ready to do.
Basically, this is a little piece that I wrote last year. It deals with the Civil War, right before the Civil War. It's kind of this guy who's a really haunted past and he's dealing with really deep action. It's a really transformative kind of piece.
Awesome. You ready?
Yeah, I am.
All right, well, good luck out there.
Now, he is a senior. He is from Highland, Michigan, and he's a communications major. He's also graduated. Oh my gosh. He's on the forensics team too, and he's going to be giving us an oratorical presentation. So please give it up for Isaac Reinberg.
You want to know what the hands down worst state in America is? Kansas. Not a doubt in my mind. Hey, look, you can argue with me if you want, that's mine. You lose, but that's what it does it for you, then I'll allow it. It's sticky, yeah, Kansas, it's sticky. The dirt's the wrong color. Snakes. All over the place. Do you have any idea how many times I have stepped outside to take a shit and there's a tornado in the backyard? Well, once, but damn, it was enough.
But Danielle on Sundays, and she comes back one day, and she walks straight up to my father on the porch, looks my father straight in the eye, and says, Daddy, what you're doing is wrong. Owning people is wrong. God made everybody the same, white and black the same, and the fact that you are owning them the eye contact and holds it. And then after what feels like a very long time, he says, Danielle, I think Sarah's had just about enough excitement for one day, don't you? How about you take her up to her room? And I got home and they had burned it, but it was still standing. And I go to go inside, but I can feel all of these bodies on the other side of the door, and I think to myself, well, that's not quite right. There should only be two people in that house. There should be my father, and there should be my little sister. But I managed to get inside. And in our living room are the bodies of all of our slaves. They were at the windows holding rifles. They were up against the door trying to stop the others from getting in. They were trying to protect my family. And I step into my little sister's room and I see her and she's curled up in a little ball. And she's not alone. Danielle is lying there right next to her, and she's got her arms wrapped around her, trying to protect her from the flames. And I don't care what you have to say about being black or white, when you are burned alive, we all come out the same color. I couldn't even tell them apart. The only way I could was because of that bracelet. This bracelet that we put on her.
Get some fresh air. Maybe I'll go kill a slave owner or something. I don't know. Maybe I'll just sit my ass in the dirt somewhere and just watch the sun.
So how you feel?
I feel good.
See, great job.
Great. Thank you very much.
Yep, as we can see, great job. Yeah. Actually, yeah. Got a chance to see it. Yeah, man, I'm blown away. That was really good, man. Thanks for giving the talents. All right, well, we're here with another performer, and your name is?
Armani Davis.
So, you wear a lot of Armani?
Yeah, I do.
Ah, she acted like it was funny. Okay, so how you feel getting ready to go on?
Oh, nervous, God, or? Yeah, I'm nervous. I'm excited at the same time, though. Okay. You know, just to do something in honor of Martin Luther King, because... Awesome. It's kind of always put to the side, but...
Awesome. So what are you going to be singing today?
I'm singing, I Believe, by Fantasia.
Ooh, that's a big one.
It's a big one.
Big one. I see you nervous, so I'm going to let you go. Good luck.
Okay,
and,
thank you.
And we'll see you afterwards.
So the next contestant that we're going to call up is a lady by the name of Armani Davis. She is a freshman here. Darius Simpson.
Are you African or black? How'd you get your hair like that? Do you play basketball? Are you a hippie? Do you think you're better than me because you wear beads? Do you play football? Are you a rapper? What is a Kimin? Is Umoja a city in Africa? Do you speak African? Where do Sankofa birds live? Are you a Black Panther? Your team does go to Team Bison. Did it hurt when they ripped the culture from your back? Did you flinch? When they snatched the ancestor from the spine of your textbook, did you blink? When they erased our history, is there a reason you want to be a bad bitch? Is there something appealing about a misbehaved dog? Do you rap because you hope to get free from these bars? Are you looking for God and true religion? What's so amazing about those genes? Is it genetic? Or is ignoring your ancestors and learning behavior? How well do you suppress your culture when asked, what nationality are you? Less conscious and a lot more coonish. My pants started hugging the lower part of my butt. Would you all stop acting like I am how I am for a reason? I didn't know. You needed an excuse to be proud of where you come from. Do you know where you come from? Do you know where you're going?
All right, we backstage is H2E once again with another performer. Tell him your name and tell him what you do.
T-Trace, I rap.
And he will be on stage now. His name is T-Trace.
And I'm still waiting. Okay, he's burning the legal, legal, pushing legal, fucking man, you can freeze the rain, the spot, like steel, and the same bastards who mistreated me. So take a heap of them on the freedom retrievers, abolish the evil, and establish a quality for my people. Yeah, and now I'm free at last. This one's for Dr. King, I'm free at last.
I ain't gonna lie, I was nervous.
You was nervous, but
hey, I had to do my thing.
You got a good reaction, and it's hard, you know, being a rapper and then, you know, going out in front of the crowd where nobody knows your music and stuff like that, and then they rock with you like you. You know what I'm saying?
Like I know most of you.
Yeah, man.
Precious Lord, take my
because leadership is about more than what you say. It's about putting into action and doing what you say. A leader does more than create followers. A leader knows that creating followers is more than just Twitter, because a leader births leaders. Dr. King and many others mobilized a movement not for applause, but they mobilized a movement for a cause. Dr. King never had any of the technological amenities. That's all. You gotta brush off the past. You gotta brush off the haters. You gotta use your haters as elevators. You gotta brush off the naysayers, the cynics, and the critics, and win this game of life. Don't tell me that you don't have the power to empower yourself and others. You have power in your mind and your hands. How will you use it? You are your greatest resource for freedom. What are you willing to work for tonight? Dr. King was more than just a dreamer. He was a doer. Do something with your gift. Do something with your talent. Do something with your education. Do something with your dream. Do something good in the hood. My brother, there's a king inside of you. My sister, there's a queen inside of you.
Wake up. Amazing. One of the best things about working in higher education is that you get to literally watch people grow up. I watched Eddie come up from his freshman year here at Eastern Michigan University, and to see him go through the things that he talked about to see where he's at, it only testifies to the glory of God. So I'm really
okay, we're here at H2E, and we're backstage with the Diversion Group. How you guys feel?
Good. Great. I'm nervous.
Can we get your name?
I'm Cliche.
Alex.
Cliche.
Never heard that before.
So I never knew this. The group was founded in 1999.
Yes, September 22nd, 1999.
Okay. Well, what would somebody do to actually audition or get into the group?
Not much. All you have to do is come to auditions, show up, show out, be good, be the best you can, and make it.
I did not spend 4 years in the Ivy League learning how to deep talk, walk, and feel.
feel in order to jump into a rage. Every time they try and kill me, I apologize because I bear resemblance most black people share. Thick lips, flat nose, and nappy hair.
I was on me.
Don't you tell me not to cry.
Ronald Reagan declared the war on drugs in 1982 at a time when drugs and crime were on a decline. Nixon was the first to turn the point. And please don't think that the war on drugs was to root out the violent offenders and the drug kingpins. Federal funding comes in with the amount of arrests. It's a numbers game, just like on the wire, and how much overtime is on their check. That's why the overseers, the AKA officers, go out and practice so many stops and frisks as possible. In New York City, 614,000 stops and frisks in 2010 alone. 87% blacks and Latinos. And you see, my mind is boggling. Because the U.S. Supreme Court never gave a thought to how they facilitated this mass on rise in mass incarceration, handing down mandatory sentences.
Third place winner, we have Lydia. Lydia, can you step up? Second place, we have T. Trace. And for first place, with a great score, we have Isaac.